Thank you very much. I'm very excited to be here today to share with you our marketing plans to unveil the new Touareg II. Forward the slide here. Really, what's exciting about Touareg is that, you know, from its success in off-road racing, Touareg was really born to lead by example, and it's exciting to have this vehicle here, which is, you know, more Touareg than ever before. And so the challenge that we had from a marketing perspective was, you know, how do we take this vehicle to market in a way that's very different, relevant, and big? From an objective standpoint, we wanted to generate awareness of Touareg II and the fact that this is a Touareg II that's, as we called it, nipped, tucked, and retuned. Secondly, we wanted to showcase the improved capabilities of the vehicle to increase consideration. And then driving traffic to VW.com is critical for Touareg II and the rest of our business because it's on VW.com when we can really deliver that deeper experience, really dive into the product and technological advancements of the new vehicle. And then secondly, just providing a call to action to get people behind the wheel of this vehicle, as you all are going to do. That once we find that once people are able to get in, and especially if they're able to do something like this drive is going to be about, you really appreciate the capabilities of the vehicle. There are two basic strategies that we employed as far as our launch goes. One was to leverage our off-road racing heritage to showcase Touareg II's capabilities. The second was to leverage Touareg II's starring role in the premiere of the Bourne Ultimatum to introduce Touareg II and generate prospects. Volkswagen has a three-year partnership with Universal Studios. And one of the opportunities that we really developed was how to integrate Touareg II, who plays a starring role in that film, to create a marketing effort around it that creates a stage that's very that delivers a lot of high visibility to it and helps us communicate that big news aspect of the launch. But before I talk about that, I want to quickly talk about the brochure and DVD. We actually invested more in this DVD and brochure than we typically do. We wanted to make it very authentic to Touareg II. We shot it in Baja, and we wanted to first capture the very rich history of off-road racing that Volkswagen really represents. Then we wanted to demonstrate what the vehicle can really accomplish. And what we did was we had Mark Miller taking a stock Touareg II through the paces, the same paces as a race Touareg goes through. And then we wanted to have an area on here that really dove deep and to demonstrate each of the products. But what I wanted to share with you was the actual DVD component. It's called The Road to Baja. And it kind of takes you through the trajectory of the history of off-road racing, how that led to Touareg today. So give you a quick glimpse at this. We'll be right back. So off-road racing, as demonstrated in the Road to Baja, is really a critical component of our marketing launch efforts behind Touareg 2. Whether it's Baja or Dakar or Pikes Peak, it's leveraging the actual race event itself from a PR and grassroots perspective to really demonstrate Touareg 2's improved capabilities. The Moab Touareg Adventure. What we wanted to do, given the experience that we know driving a Touareg really delivers, was to create an event that really captures the excitement of racing, but puts it in the hands of everybody. And what this event is it's really what we really describe it as is the ultimate VW Touareg driving experience. It showcases the capabilities of the new vehicle, but in a very authentic, real-world setting. And so it involves multiple audiences. It's getting people from prospects to owners to media to dealers to internal staff to our marketing partners, anybody who might be a prospect to buy the vehicle or could influence a prospect to buy the vehicle, getting them in the vehicle and allowing them to experience it. And this just gives you a quick glimpse of somebody's reaction to it.
Something I never would have done for myself, but I'm so glad I came to be eating on the top of a mountain, driving, seeing these trails. This is like Old West stuff, but it's beautiful. I mean, I can't believe everything we're doing in a Touareg out here. It's just unbelievably amazing. The view is incredible, the weather, the people. It's probably one of the most awesome experiences I've ever had. It's really great.
I mentioned the importance of the web earlier on VW.com. This is the current homepage right now on our site. And one of the ways that we wanted to express the capabilities of Touareg was we wanted to not get too techy in terms of the homepage. We wanted people to basically go on and be able to link to that content that they wanted. But to explain our competitive advantage, we wanted to have a little fun with it. And on the homepage, we admit that Touareg 2 tests positive for performance-enhancing OGT, or as we call it, off-road German technology. So some may call it cheating. We just wanted to build the most worthy off-road vehicle possible. But that once you get into the site, you're able to really dive deep and really understand what it is that makes Touareg perform. Okay, we'll talk a little bit now about the Bourne Ultimatum. I think that this movie really represents a great property for us. The movie itself and the content itself is a great fit. For those who aren't familiar, this is the third installment of the Bourne series. Very successful, big blockbuster. The first two films grossed about $300 million in the U.S. And about $450 worldwide. And if you've seen the films, you'll know that car chases tend to be the emotional centerpiece of these films. They're known for their very dramatic car chases, and through a product placement opportunity, the Touareg 2 has a starring role. The antagonist character in the movie, Paz, is driving a black Touareg 2, chasing Matt Damon, who's in a police car, through the streets of Manhattan, a very high-speed, dramatic chase scene in New York. And in fact, Men's Journal called it one of the greatest car chase scenes in Hollywood history, which is high praise. So what we wanted to do with that footage is we wanted to take that footage and we wanted to create a marketing effort around that footage. And we first created a commercial around it that involved both the footage from the movie as well as footage that we shot and recreated to look like the scene in the movie, to bring those two elements together and create a very high impact commercial that draws people to VW.com. We also wanted to kind of play upon a very successful campaign that we launched last year involving Jetta and safety. So I'll show you that commercial right now.
We have a situation. Bourne showed up on our surveillance.
They erased his identity.
Jason Bourne is at large in New York City.
They stole his past.
Eliminate the threat.
On August 3rd, see what happens when Bourne finally comes home.
Holy.
So that commercial will air on begin airing on July 21st, up until the premiere of the movie. On these programs here, both network and cable programming. Again, we also wanted to drive people to the web. It was very important. So we have a partnership with Google called the Ultimate Search for Born that kicked off on the 16th of July. And it's a way to kind of draw people in. It's a trivia game built around this movie, the Born series. Turek 2 is also the grand prize. And I think importantly, too, one of the things that is featured in this this promotion is we have access to behind-the-scenes footage from the film itself that shows Turek putting through its paces as the movie was being filmed. And so that content is a great way to draw people in to the promotion as well. So I wanted to share with you that behind-the-scenes content. You can get a feel for what I'm talking about.
This car here is Paz's car. He's in pursuit of Bourne in New York Street. Bourne's driving an NYPD Impala.
Matt Damon and Paul Greengrass says, well, we gotta have a car chase in New York. That's not easy. New York is one of the busiest, most complicated environments to shoot in the world.
We've got various crashes and junctions to drive through, so we need a lot of footage of our man Paz in the action.
We try and be incredibly real, and you know, I think the audience feels it.
Take your spots. If you don't need to be here, please don't be here. No.
It's blown me away, actually, to tell you the truth, how hard we've been hitting this thing. I mean, that's all I've been basically doing is slamming into cars, and as you can see, it's still running.
It's a SUV, very powerful one, so I'm pretty excited. I love German cars.
The Turek's doing absolutely fantastically.
It definitely feels like a very safe car. I'd drive one at home. I'd put my wife and kids in that all day.
So our web efforts as well online are built around that online content, and how can we use that to draw people in, as well as playing up the five-star rating in the Safe Happens connection. And then in terms of the homepage will shift to begin to play up the whole Bourne Ultimatum tie-in. And again, you can go in and get all that content, and also there's a test drive offer here that involves tickets to get, again, to try to draw people into the showroom to test drive the new vehicle. We also wanted to ensure that we were able to activate this locally. Our dealers are very excited about it. So we actually, in our top 14 markets, are having pre-screenings of the film. And there's tickets and DVDs as well associated with the assets that the dealers have for test drive offers or promotions. And in fact, today we have for you guys on the way out a DVD set of the first two films that are packaged with a special VW packaging. As well, that we will make available to you on your way out today. I couldn't give you the new one because they would sue me if I did that. So I have to give you the two previous. So, yeah, I know. Lastly, another good thing when you can get a movie tie-in to work well. And movie tie-ins don't always work well. There's a lot of headaches involved. But this has really come together in a very positive way. Is that you're also able to benefit from the support, the promotional support that Universal puts behind it. So in terms of the integration in the movie trailer, content, Turek 2 content on the DVD release of this movie in November and December, and the other things that you see listed here as well, you're able to kind of make your marketing dollars go further. And so I think with that, you know, we think the combination of playing up the racing heritage and how that translates into the Turek's product capabilities, and then this Bourne tie-in will help us launch the vehicle with some fanfare and excitement that we think it deserves. And with that, I'm going to ask Keith and Steve to come back up for a quick Q&A. Thank you.